12 minutes in front of 10. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. And as we mentioned earlier, STAX Museum here in Memphis was voted among the best music museums in the entire United States and Canada. But they're not the only museum here in the Mid-South that made the USA Today 10 Best list. Four out of the first five winners are located in Nashville and Memphis.
And at the number six spot, 8 and 9 all find their homes in the Mississippi Delta. This morning, though, we're going to go back live to STAX in Soulsville, USA, to see this award-winning experience, what it has to offer. And we're joined by STAX's Director of Education, Kimberly Hooper-Taylor. Kimberly, thank you for joining us. For those who experience STAX for the first time, are just absolutely blown away, what makes it so unusual? What makes it stand out?
What makes it so unique? We are the Memphis Community Music Museum. Its authenticity, I think, is one. When you think about Southern Soul and Memphis Soul and just not only the creativity, but the opportunity that existed not only in the 60s and 70s, but the opportunity that exists today for teens and young adults to kind of further their music careers and wherever they want to be involved in musically, it still exists today. So we are the museum that is still operating like it once did in the 60s and 70s, and to me that's incredibly unique.
Show us a little bit, Kimberly, about where you are right now, and while you walk us through, is it mostly like baby boomers who listened to the music back in the day, or are young people just as fascinated with the history?
Oh my goodness, so this is not just for boomers. Young people are absolutely interested in this music. In fact, we call it a very hip museum. When we came on with the education department, we are attracting more young people. The STAX Music Academy also attracts young people. The artifacts they appeal to everybody. It's music. Music is universal, like love and sports. So it not only attracts boomers, but it attracts millennials and Generation Z, and even my infant son comes here, and we have Mommy and Me classes. So it's for everybody.
It definitely seems like it is for everybody, Kimberly. And also, you have a number of people from across the pond, as they say, people from Europe who really appreciate STAX. Why do you think they are so into it?
You know what? That is pretty much our base. We attract mostly international visitors. These people experience STAX on a whole different level. They were in those seats at those concerts when these artists were traveling to Europe, and they want to come back and relive that time. They want to pay homage to those artists, and they are more than welcome here at the STAX Recording Studio Museum today. So absolutely, they definitely come.
What is your favorite part of the museum?
Is that a fair question? I would have to say the room that we're standing in now. So this is Studio A. This is where most of our programming takes place. STAX does over 50 free programs a year. If you can see the artwork that's on the walls in this studio right now, those are done by Colonial Middle School. They highlight our Women of Memphis Soul exhibit. We have school tours and programs. We have movie nights, and all those things usually take place in this studio. So this place can flip from just music studio to live concert arena to even we've had some dance sessions. And so this is probably one of my favorite rooms in the museum for sure.
All right, Kimberly, it is one of the coolest places on the planet.
It really is. Thank you so much, and congratulations again on your honor. Definitely
well
deserved. Thank you, Kimberly.
Thank you.